In a recent video, I showed you how to animate a still image and have a jet fighter flying through your screen, like you can see here. What I want to show you in this video is a more practical use of the animation features of iMovie, and we will get a logo and we'll have it drop down into the screen and bounce at the bottom of your screen, and we'll also animate text to drop down or come in from the side and to move around the iMovie screen and perhaps to fly out to the right. To do this, we're going to open Keynote and we'll select the basic black theme. Just remove these titles for now, they're not necessary. The important thing that we do need to do here is that we need to go to the color fill and make that no fill. And we also want to do the same thing on the master slide so that there is no fill showing. I'm Bruce Macbryde, and my goal is to improve your knowledge and speed up your workflow within iMovie. Now that we've got a clear screen, the first thing we're going to do is select some text. We'll type in the text and then we'll move it to the left-hand side of the screen. And now we will go to Animate and we will select Build In and we'll add an effect. And our first effect is going to be Drop. And you can see the bounces built in there. Then we're going to select an action, and on this action, let's select, say, pop. And then we'll select build out, and on the build out, we'll select another effect, and let's on this one select fly out, and it'll fly out to the right-hand side of the screen. We will perhaps just decrease the duration of that a little so that it happens a little quicker. That looks good. So from here, what we need to do is now export this, and we will go to export and select movie. And from here, we're going to select custom and select this ProRes, making sure export with transparent background is cleared. That will now save that. We'll give it a title and we will now drag that into iMovie, and there is the text. We simply will put that on top of the clip, and if we play that now, you can see that it's come in and it shoots out to the right. Now, this is a little bit slow for us, so what we want to do is to come to modify and we'll select fast forward. Let's select four times. Perhaps that's a little bit too much. So we'll select that on there and have that come in at the end, pop in and slide out. So that covers how to use the text. You could, if you wanted to, with this text while it's there, if you select that text there, you could change it to fit and then as a picture in picture, you could move it, position it in different parts of the screen. You could use the keyframe animation that we looked at in that previous tutorial. Click the eye above to go to that tutorial. And the next thing we'll do is look at creating a logo bounce. That's a drop down and bounce. So we'll use the iMovie logo and we'll simply drag that into the timeline. And then as you look in there, you can see it's full size and the Ken Burns is affected. So we'll select on that and make it fit. And then we'll go to the overlay button and select here, picture in picture. So what we want to do is to take it to the end point where it's going to finish. And we're going to finish about a third of the way down, and so that it will drop from the top, and by the time it gets to this position where it is now, it will have done its bounce. So while it's there, we will select on it and put a keyframe in there. And we're now going to move with the left hand arrow four frames to the left. One, two, three, four. And we're going to take this up and use the shift key. Now we're going to go another four frames to the left. Two, three, four. And we will bring it back down again using the shift key to make sure that it stays on a horizontal plane. And four more presses of the left-hand arrow, and then we will take it back up again, four more presses, and then bring it down again, four more presses. Now, we have it at the bottom of the screen. We now want to take the playhead to the beginning of the clip, and we'll take the dissolve off here so that it shows straight away. And now with the shift key down, we'll drag it up and off the screen. And so that when we play it now, it's going to drop down, bounce at the bottom, and stay in that location. And then we'll see our animated text. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe, because I will be offering more videos for those who press the bell.